to the World Cup starts here for England. From now on in, it matters. Rooney. And here's Joe Cole again, and it's two. And Walcott has scored for England. Theo Walcott, what a night for the teenager. It couldn't be, could it? It is, you know, it's a hat-trick for Theo Walcott. Just sensational. Should be the goalkeepers, it's not, it's Rio Ferdinand. And England at long last have their lead. Rooney! And that should put this contest beyond doubt. Gerrard will strike it! How to banish self-doubt! It's Beckham. It's Gerrard, and it's a pin by Terry! And England have their late goal! Play 5, 1-5. A job well done!
With tired legs, but inspired hearts, England have made the furthest of trips to the edge of Europe. The domestic season may be over, but the international one for Fabio Capello has two more crucial matches to go. Today in Kazakhstan, Wednesday at Wembley. Theo Walcott's season ended 2 weeks ago. Well, worth the trip out there for the 1,500 fans who've travelled halfway across the globe to follow Fabio Capello's so far perfect qualification. A distinctly Asian feel about this European tie. Kazakhstan connected with Europe and North Africa via the old Silk Road in the Middle Ages. But who will take the riches today? We're in Borat's backyard for Kazakhstan against England. Game 6 of Group 6, exclusively live here on Setanta Sports. Good afternoon. You may feel the hard work has already been done by England and Fabio Capello, but they haven't booked their plane tickets to South Africa yet. A win today and another on Wednesday, and they might be able to. With me, two men who've been by my side since this World Cup campaign started back in September in Barcelona.
It's been terrible.
Steve McManaman and Terry Venables, not being able to get rid of them. How much of a test is this for England this afternoon?
I think it'll be a good test for them, Angus. I think it'll be difficult. I don't expect it to be a walkover. I think the lads who play for Man United and Chelsea should you know, walk into the game quite comfortably because they're still on the back of two big results. A lot of other lads have been away and have had a few days on the beach. So if anything, I think that it's just getting focused again, getting the results over and done with, getting a victory and coming back to play Andorra on Wednesday.
Is that time on the beach, Terry, actually good because they need a rest, or you actually lose the impetus at the end of the season?
No, I don't think so. I think you can do with a break, that's all. Just a quick break, you get a relaxing, and you know always that's in the back of your mind. It's very important to know a really top game for his. That's all they'll be thinking about. Although they'll be resting their body, their mind won't be resting.
It hasn't been 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks on the beach, has it? You know, where, you know, you could lose your shape, whatever. It's been a couple of days, hasn't it? As Teddy said, a bit of relaxing recuperation won't do anybody any harm.
And if there's one thing that Fabio Capello has seemingly been able to do before, it's focus these players' minds.
Well, they've been excellent, haven't they? And, you know, we've travelled away from home with England, and they've been fantastic. Croatia, you know, the first game was you know, neither here nor there against Andorra, but certainly against Croatia, Belarus, great performances, arguably the better performances away from home. And we expect another one today. These are the most difficult games, aren't they, away from home, no matter who you play.
Yeah, is jet lag and tiredness any sort of... Fabio Capello doesn't want to say it's an excuse, but is it a concern at all, Terry?
No, I don't think so. The desire is going to be all of that. But once you start getting up there, out there, getting training with the lads, you're back into it straight away. You get ready before the game now. And as soon as the ball's kicked, they'll be fine. They'll be great. But they've got to make the performance happen. They've got to really dig in, because this is one that could be tricky if it starts wrong.
Yeah.
But we're following up with Andorra. It's ideal, really.
Yeah.
You just hope that your big players are fit, and they are, and they play well.
Yeah, I agree. I think if England start very quickly today, very fast, good tempo, closing the opposition down, the game could effectively be over at half-time. If they start slow because of the weather, because they're a bit tired, it could be drawn into one of those long, drawn-out games where we're trying to break them down or we can't. And you don't want it to peter out. You want them to be sharp right from minute one today.
OK, well, plenty more from Stephen Terry here and also the mood from the camp out in Kazakhstan. And if you want to watch this one and you're not already a subscriber, press your red button now or visit our website or call us on either of those two numbers. Well, part of our team, Dan Rowan, and co-commentator Chris Waddle are inside the Central Stadium in Almaty already and have some team news for us.
Yes, thank you, Angus. We're a long way from home at the end of a very long and hard season, but Fabio Capello has now named the 11 men who he thinks can do a job here in Almaty this evening. A fantastic atmosphere, as you can hear, and a first start for England for Robert Green. What a chance this will be for the West Ham goalkeeper. This is how England line up here then this evening in Almaty at the Central Stadium here in Kazakhstan. In goal, as I say, Rob Green at the back, Johnson, Terry, Upson and Cole in midfield, Lampard and Barry holding just ahead of them, Walcott, Rooney and Gerrard, and Emil Heskey up front. He fights off the challenge of Peter Crouch. That's England. What are their opponents then this evening? Kazakhstan. Not many familiar names there, of course, but look out for Kukayev. He scored, of course, against England back in October in that 5-1 defeat at Wembley. Ostapenko is a Russian-born striker, a big target man. He's played for Royal Antwerp, and he will be a threat, they tell me, for England this evening. That's how the two teams line up. Chris Waddle, our co-commentator, joins me pitchside, as you can see. Chris, what do you make of Fabio Capello's team?
Well, it's more what we expected. Obviously, the loss of Rio Ferdinand gives another chance for Matthew Upson. And it's nice to see Robert Green going in. He needs experience, hopefully not be troubled too much tonight. But this and Wednesday are two good games to come into.
You get the impression, don't you, Chris, that Fabio Capello has now settled on a formation that he likes?
Yeah, he likes that 4-5-1. And obviously look out for Rooney changing with Gerrard if it's not working or he's not happy about it. You've got to get Gerrard on the ball. And sometimes it's better for them to push him inside and tell Rooney to come and play on the left.
No excuses, Fabio Capello says. Will he need any tonight? Any chance of a slip-up?
No, I've got to say that I've watched his train lot all week, Kazakhstan. They're a dangerous side, but they're not the best physical shape, so I think England really control the second half, so they've just got to protect the first half. But the pitch is a great level tonight, Dan. The pitch is not the best condition.
I was going to say, it's warm here, it's a great atmosphere, but the pitch has been the source of much conjecture. You can see they've been rolling it here this evening, they've been putting the lines down as well, but it's bumpy. And it's not what England players are used to, is it, Chris?
No, it's definitely not. And as you saw, you can see now it's been rolled. The sprinkling system, I've probably got a better one in my garden, I'll be honest. And from the corner flags, absolutely terrible, where they've actually covered them with pieces of astroturf. And, you know, these are not looking... People seeing it now, this is just a bit of turf with a white lane on it.
How dangerous is that, Chris?
Very dangerous. I mean, your footing can easily give way on that. And I'm really surprised that FIFA haven't done something about this.
Chris Waddle, thank you for your thoughts. Make no mistake, this is a challenge for England for so many reasons. A long way from home, very much a trip into the unknown.
Thanks both very much indeed. No surprises in that team?
No, not for me. No, I think the only surprise would have been maybe Crouch for Heskey, because arguably Peter Crouch's form at the end of the season has been better than Heskey's, who was suffering from an injury. But, you know, Capello likes Heskey and he wants him as a target man. And normally if Heskey plays and does well, the people around him, i.e. Rooney's and Gerrard, normally pick off the pieces and score goals.
Bearing in mind that the state of the pitch, as we saw, it looks very bumpy. You see, you know, you have to wear a seatbelt when you roll it on one of those things.
And a cigarette as well. Like.
is it more likely that Emil Heskey will get the ball quicker than England would usually?
Well, they've got to start quick. They've got to stop them getting any confidence at all. And to have Heskey in the side, who I think does play well for England, and he has done that. He has had problems with injuries. That's been his main issue. But I think he's quick. He's going to lead the line. What you've got in this team, you've got a lot of talent, which we know, and you've got a lot of guys with industry. They will want to work. So it's not a case of one team, you know, outmaneuvering by just getting stuck into them, into us, and then we're all going to fall over. That's not going to happen. But we have got the talent as well. But if we do let them out chase us, that would be a bit of hysteria will come into the game, and that is what will give us a problem if we don't stay nice and cool.
And a first start for Robert Green.
Yeah. And he's been in good form for West Ham. West Ham have had a tremendous season, haven't they? You know, he's complained in the past about being number six or number five. Well, he's number one now, and it's up to him. If he has a good game, hopefully it'll be very quiet and he'll have another quiet game on Wednesday. We hope. as Chrissy Waddle said, it'll do us confidence, you know, the world of good. You want to start in little easy games, and hopefully tonight will be one. I think it's important that England do get the ball down and pass it well tonight.
He has been sort of less good on crosses and in the air. Is that fair enough?
I think we can. Yeah, I think he has been a bit wobbly on crosses, but I think anybody would be wobbly on crosses.
Oh, they are. Stoke. Yeah, exactly.
Stoke. I think we could pick holes in everybody, I think.
He's very quick.
Crosses.
He's very quick. He's very brave. His positioning's good. He comes solid, or he'll check very quick and make sure he protects the goal. And I think he's a good goalkeeper.
And he deserves a chance to tell you, doesn't he?
I spoke to him a couple of times, and he is very confident, and he has been asking for this job, and he's got his opportunity. And as we were just saying just now, he's had a good season.
Yeah. Okay. I think with the goalkeepers we've got, he's certainly the right game, and he's certainly ahead of the other two goalkeepers at the moment.
Okay. Little geography lesson for you now. Kazakhstan is the 9th largest country in the world. In fact, it's bigger than the whole of Western Europe. It's a land of diversity, inhabited by just over 16 million people. It declared independence in 1991, the last Soviet republic to do so. And the former capital, Almaty, where today's game takes place, is just 200 miles from the Chinese border. In fact, England is closer to New York than Almaty. Not that that has stopped hundreds of England fans making their way to the far east corner of Europe, who are as happy as the players just to be there.
I've been in all of Fabio's squads apart from the first one, so obviously I'm over the moon about that and couldn't be more grateful.
Follow the Tiger today, the Memorial Tournament, Day 3, 5.30 Setanta Golf and 9 o'clock here on Setanta Sports 1. And also tonight, 9 o'clock, see how the Republic of Ireland get on against Bulgaria in Group 8. And Wales are in Group 4 action against Azerbaijan. That's over on Setanta Sports 2 at 9. And check out the website today. There's a counter to see how many cliches our commentary team come up with. £5,000 is heading to the Bobby Moore Foundation, but that figure will be reduced every time there's a cliche from our team. Also, check out the site for all the transfer news during the close season. £25,000 in the Central Stadium in Almaty. Extra Portaloos and refreshment kiosks have been brought in. Dan has got some of the fans now.
Well, we're 3,500 miles away from you in the United Kingdom, but England will not be wanting for support here this evening. 1,500 travelling fans for Fabio Capello's side, and a few of them are here with me now. Guys, it's a long way to come.
Yeah, very long way to come. Got to support your country, haven't you? And it's a bit of a different place than the usual places.
What do you make of Kazakhstan?
Fantastic place.
It's nice, is it?
Fantastic place. Trouble is, the football game gets in the way. Have a good weekend with all the lads.
Have you got here? Have you flown in?
Flew into Turkey, and then here today, and here for two more nights, but people are lovely, great time, and I've got to say, it's a friendly place.
England playing well, 100% record so far. Prediction for tonight?
4-1.
I assume to England?
Of course.
And you, sir?
5-0 England, but if Kazakhstan win, we'll have a great night.
Guys, thanks for your time. Well, England fans have had plenty to support and cheer about in recent times. Will Fabio Capello's man make it 6 out of 6? We'll find out a little later on.
He's in a win-win situation, that guy.
5-0 on a drink.
Oh, dear. It's been a terrific return to form for Glenn Johnson at the back of this season, which has meant he's been able to secure his spot in the England starting lineup. Well, Dan has been talking to the Portsmouth right-back about today's new experience.
Obviously, it's the unknown. Obviously, the majority of the squad's never been here before. Obviously, it's going to be a tough team on a tough pitch. And obviously, like the sleeping patterns as well, obviously messed up when you're here for such a short time.
You've started the last four games now, Glenn, for England. How important has it been to you to become an established member of this side?
Well, obviously, I'm enjoying playing for England at the moment, and I just want to basically keep the run going as long as I can and play and start as many games as possible.
Is Fabio Capello the best manager you've ever worked under?
Yeah, I'd say so. Obviously, it worked under Mourinho and Claudio and Harry, and they're all fantastic managers in their own rights, but yeah, I'd say Capello would definitely be up there, yeah.
Are you scared of him?
Not scared of him, but you know he'll kick you up the backside if you're not doing it right, so...
Is that what England needed, do you think?
I think so, yeah. They probably had it too easy beforehand and were getting away with too much.
What was the turning point, when it came to England?
I think playing consistently at a club, really. Obviously, before, when I first went to Chelsea, I was in and out of the team and then obviously in and out of the squads as well. So, obviously, I think by playing it week in, week out at Portsmouth, it's given me a chance to show myself.
And how grateful are you to Fabio Capello to bringing you back into the side and showing such faith in you?
Yeah, obviously, I'm over the moon about it. Obviously, I've been in all of Fabio's squads apart from the first one, so obviously I'm over the moon about that and couldn't be more grateful.
Two over the moons and too many obviously is to count. It is only the commentators that we're worried about with
that.
Clichés. Otherwise, the Bobby Moore Foundation would have no money left. Glenn Johnson has had a great end to the season.
I think he's had a great season, really. He's, I think everybody will be surprised if he's still at Portsmouth next year. There's a lot of suitors out there who would like to take him. He's turned himself into a marauding right back, and you can't buy that, those type of players nowadays. He's really come on leaps and bounds just by playing week in, week out for Portsmouth.
You've got the boss watching you just for your warm-ups as well. You've got to perform, haven't you?
Yeah, you have. But I think he's done terrifically well defensively. That's what the thing. Because he was always good going forward. He was really a midfield player, midfield player. And that's what I felt. But he goes into right back, and he didn't really get the best of his defensive work, but he's got over that, and he's got over it consistently, so that we hope that will continue, because there's no doubt he's going to be a big asset going down at right side.
Yeah. Gareth Barry, still in the England squad, but now with a different club. What have you made of his move? It's a big change since his last international.
Well, I think we all knew he was going to move, Angus. I think after... I think the only surprise was the team he went.
Why has he gone to Manchester City?
I think he's gone to Manchester City just because he's had a meeting with Mark Hughes. Mark Hughes has laid out the timetable of events where he wants to take Manchester City forward. He knows there's huge investments, and it could be this roller coaster ride of hopefully Champions League glory in the end. I still think it'll take a while. I mean, I don't harp on necessarily about the money, because if he would have joined Liverpool, he'd be very well paid. If he would have signed a new contract with Aston Villa, he would have been extremely well paid. I think he's gone because Mark Hughes has showed him a vision of which he wants to be part of.
But his role in the England setup is consistent, isn't it?
Yeah, now it is.
It is, because he and Frank Lampard have had a good relationship. And I think that they're both are tenacious now in that position. They both can score a goal, and the thing about people saying about Eskies really doesn't score enough, you've got Gerrard, Rooney, Walcott and the two boys in midfield that can make up for those goals. So that's very, very helpful.
OK, let's hear from the Kazakhstani boss now, Bernd Stork.
Bernd, just how difficult a challenge does your side face tonight?
I will see. I hope we can make a very good game, like in England, in Wembley. We make the first half a very good game, but in the second half we lost a little bit endurance. We have not so good fitness for 90 minutes, but I hope for today it will be a good game for us.
Just how big a match is this for Kazakhstan?
I think it's the biggest in the history of Kazakhstan. I think all the people expecting a good game from us, and all people are coming now and visiting the game on the television. I think it will be great for this country, Kazakhstan.
Do you believe you have any chance of causing an upset tonight?
I hope it. I hope it that we get that we shoot a goal. It's a big aim from us that we can make a good game in the first half, perhaps. Sometimes when we have a little chance to shoot a goal.
Best of luck, Ben.
He paused a long time before answering that question, whether they had a chance.
I think he just wants them to shoot on goal, I think.
I think he should have just said no, we haven't got a chance.
It would have been easier, wouldn't it?
But they have, do they?
I think, realistically, we would still say no. I think he mentioned there in the first half, because it was the same at Wembley, the fit lads, at least the fit, they're organised, they will try and, contain England, certainly until the first half. But you think once the second half starts, the level of our fitness, the level of our quality of football should overcome Kazakhstan today. Mm. Kazakhstan lost 5-1 at home to Belarus, who are not the strongest of opposition. So you'd think it was a penalty kick, but I'd just be happy with a 1-0 victory today. I don't necessarily need to see England win 6-0 away from home, to be able to judge them today. I'll judge them on other performances.
Of the goals that Kazakhstan have scored in this qualifying tournament, Ostapenko is the man who's got most of them. A big unit, as they say, up front.
Yeah, and he scored, and I mean, admittedly, he did score a couple against Andorra, but still, he scored goals. He's got three out of the six goals, as we can see there. And he'll be aggressive. He'll try and put himself about, as we like to say. And the centre-halves will certainly know, you know, they're in with a game today. He'll try, and that's all you can ask of sometimes inferior opposition. But as long as they work hard and make it difficult for the defenders to bring the ball out and play, that's all you can ask of them.
Yeah, but most of them play in Kazakhstan. Yeah. They only know that way, don't they?
Yeah, they do. I mean, that's all they know. But I think these teams know it's their big game.
Yeah.
And they're just going to put everything into it. They don't really think that they can win this game. But the game, I've been around it too long to make too much of a rash decision. Yeah. But I would say that we've got to learn to do our part. We've got to make sure we say we've got to be ruthless, we've got to be professional, and the main thing, we've come a long way. Let's get this the job done before we get back.
Yeah, I think if they hold out for a draw till half time, it's a success, you know, like it was in Andorra.
Yeah.
They just defend, drop back, and if it's 0-0 at half time, brilliant. We've won the game as such.
Yeah.
But it's up to England to, as Telly said, put pressure on them, and they'll make mistakes.
Okay, another history lesson for you. The people of Kazakhstan speak Kazakh and Russian. They're the one of the world's top 10 oil producers and have an abundant supply of other resources, including natural gas, uranium, and gold, and fruit, it seems. Islam is the country's most popular religion, ahead of Orthodox Russian Christianity, and the Zenkov Cathedral in Almaty is the second tallest wooden building in the world. But all anyone is interested in is getting a ticket for the game. You have your ticket with us.
Focus on those two games, because I think it's really the biggest step to go to World Cup.
Next Saturday at 8 o'clock, the UFC 99 continues. It's the comeback. 8 o'clock, Satanta Sports 1. And then also next Saturday, 2 in the morning, boxing for you, Miguel Cotto against Joshua Clotty. That's over on Satanta Sports 2. Finely tuned and focused, Fabio Capello says there is no room for excuses. The Capello team has its eyes set on another perfect result. Well, so far, England have been faultless in their bid for World Cup qualification. Played 5, won 5. That deserves a big hand. But England got a slow hand clap at half-time against Andorra. Their first qualifier under Capello had started poorly. But after the break, there was no looking back.
Rooney, and here's Joe Cole again, and it's 2. That's what you call a substitution.
People look at it on paper and think it's an easy game, but they got 10 men behind the ball, and it made it difficult.
It's a case of hold on tight. Is this the night when we finally see the fruits of Fabio Capello's labours? It'll come for Walcott, and Walcott has scored for England! Theo Walcott, what a night for the teenager. Here's Wayne Rooney to make it 3. And Croatia at least are on the score sheet. It's Walcott, it couldn't be, could it? It is, you know, it's a hat-trick for Theo Walcott. Theo Walcott, the youngest player out there, the hero.
He just showed to everyone how strong he was as a unit. Just proved it tonight, it was absolutely brilliant.
The new Wembley stages a World Cup qualifier for the very first time. It's Rio Ferdinand and England have their lead. And it's in. England double their lead. What's Ashley Cole done? He's given a goal to Kazakhstan, that's what. Rooney! This time it's his goal. And it's Rooney who scores. Defoe can make it 5 for England. He has. It's 3 more points on the trail towards South Africa. England's World Cup campaign taking them east against opponents both confident and competent. Gerrard will strike it. Out of vanish out. And Belarus are level. Rooney waiting. Rooney scoring! It's lovely. It's Rooney. It's a chance. It's a burn.
We're in a comfortable position at the minute, so if we can keep playing in this form, I'm sure we'll be okay.
England's World Cup qualification campaign enters its fifth step. It's Terry, it's Crouch, it's 1-0. Shevchenko! Wouldn't you just know it? And it's obtained by Terry. And England have their late goal. A job well done. Played by. They take another significant stride towards South Africa.
And this is what the table looks like, as John was saying. England played five, won five, 5 points clear of Croatia and Ukraine, of course, who play each other later on today. Kazakhstan with 3 points from their five games. England's goal scorers made up of Wayne Rooney, who scored five, three of those away from home. Theo Walcott with that hat-trick in Croatia, of course, and Joe Cole, who came to the rescue in Barcelona with 2 second-half goals against Andorra. The difference between these two sides, England ranks 6 in the world at the moment, Kazakhstan 132nd. Would anything other than a victory be a huge blow to England's qualification at the moment? Or are they so far clear at the moment?
I think it wouldn't matter that. Yeah,
much.
I think they're so far clear. We've got to play Andorra at home, Croatia at home, which you'd expect them to win at Wembley. I think it'll be a shock. Personally, it'll be a shock if they don't win tonight. But I don't think it'll be a huge blow going forward for qualifying. I don't. Croatia and Ukraine, as we know, will take points off each other tonight. So that will strengthen England going into Wednesday's game, but I still expect him to get 3 points.
Terry, how far can Fabio Capello look ahead at the moment? Clearly he's concentrating on this, but he will have thoughts of South Africa, won't he, in his mind?
He will, without a shadow of a doubt. And he's now got to go really through what he has to finish this off, but all the time he will be confident. Mm. And this is you could say a tricky game, but I really don't believe it will be. But if it was and it was a draw, you've got the possibility now of getting another 3 points, which we should definitely get against Andorra. If we ever did something wrong there, I think it could be in for a stormy ride. But there's no doubt. I mean, we've done all the hard work, and certainly in these two games coming up, I bet you they're really looking forward to it. They're looking to see like how many they can win by. That's what they've got to say. Come on, this has got to be done. We're not going to give a goal away. That's our goalkeeper's hat trick. No goals against, and then let's get some goals out for us. I think that they will be in a good mood. Yeah, the pitch is bad. Get over that and win the fight to start with. Knock them down, their confidence, the opposition, and then play.
Is there a sense of pride as well that, you know, you can go maybe unbeaten in this qualifying?
Most definitely. If you go under, you know, we're talking about it's the best ever start now. You know, if they win tonight, if they win on against Andorra and the results go the way they could have qualified 7 from 7, you know, of course there's a huge amount of pride if you just go and steamroll right through your group. It fills you with a lot of confidence. It must fill the manager with a lot of confidence. And going forward, when you know you're going to have to play some of the bigger teams, when you know that you're unbeaten in a large amount of games, I think it's a fantastic thing. If you look around Europe, Portugal are struggling at the moment, the likes of France are struggling. So it's there for England. England's up there with the Spanish, are playing the best football and got the best record around at the moment.
And perhaps get the job done this week, if it's not done already. And then he can start trying out a few other players.
I think that what he's got to do is got to try. The trouble is, if you put too many sort of guys in that haven't played before, they're not going to get the help from the rest of the players. So you're all going in there together. That will give you something. But you need to, if it doesn't go quite right, you've got the other guys there to give you a safety, a passage all the way through in your own game. And I think that's important, because it's so easy to go in and not do well altogether. And then they would be a bit disappointed. Yeah. I think there's no doubt about it. The team is confident. The manager's confident. And they feel good about it. get one or two in that you think, because it's not the players that are playing are going to be a problem. It's those that haven't played
who we
might need. I mean, just like the last time out, a lot of the players got injuries. You've got to be fortunate. You get injuries, it's not those players that are important. It's the ones coming in. If they haven't got any preparation, that's not going to be good.
I think if we qualify early, instead of having 2, 3, 4 friendlies before going into South Africa, conceivably, we could have 6 or 7 friendlies. So, I mean, you know, that will help them out in the long run. But I agree with Teddy, you can't just throw 7, 8 new faces into one game. But you can put one or two in and, you know, put them in.
I'd say you can have 2 or 3 or 4. Yeah. Because then you might have a situation when you're going to play your big games, like Croatia and Ukraine, where you have got some injuries. Mm. And that is the only doubt. And that's trying to cover every eventuality, which you have to think about.
OK. Let's hear from Fabio Capello now, who's had to keep his squad on its toes at the end of a very long, hard season.
The problem is that the end of the Premier League was 10 days ago. And some players went to holiday, some players played, some players won, some players lost. You have to recover the spirit, you have to rebuild the group, to play with the national team, with the senior. It's an honor to play. And all the players that are here are very happy to stay.
It's very much a trip into the unknown for England. It's the first time they've been here. How difficult are the conditions?
Usually we play the wet grass, and the ball is... when the pass is through, it's a speeder that to dry grass. This is possible problem. It's one of the possible problem, but no problem for the waiter, no problem for the jet lag. It's not excuse, this.
No excuses?
No excuses. When we played in Wembley, Kazakhstan played very well. We won 5-1, but was not so easy game because they pressing a lot, running a lot, and with the ball he played well. We have to focus in these 2 games because I think this is really the biggest step to go to South Africa. We played well, we won 5 games, but every game is a different story. And we have to play here tomorrow, and we have to win.
Well, the 1,500 England fans all settling in to the Central Stadium in Almaty, looking forward to the 6th qualification game of England's World Cup campaign. Bit of jet lag there. Pre-match nap. Someone give him a nudge before kickoff.
False touch.
How will it go? You expect, as Fabio was talking there, that it'll be England trying to press and impose
themselves
straight
away? I think
so.
We'll have most of the ball. We'll try. They will defend, I think. Angus very deep. As I said, try and hold out to half-time, like Andorra did, like Kazakhs did at Wembley. But if we score an early goal, you know, I can see us winning. I can see us winning by many goals anyway. But as I said before, in these games, difficult pitch, any victory you do for me tonight.
OK. Well, on the other side of this break, it's kick-off time. England in action again. It's time to end the season with a flourish. My horse. The bloke next to me is a horse. Well, Kazakhstan, England on its way. But don't forget, here at Setenta, we're not just about football.
I guess it's the 46 live Barclays Premier League games.
I've got the FPL.
You can't beat the passion of the FA Cup.
What about international football? They've got World Cup qualifiers too, you know what I'm saying?
And don't forget all those England friendlies here at the home of football.
Plus, next season, I can watch the Europa League.
There is nothing better than watching Tiger in full swing. Have some of that.
Personally, I prefer the rough stuff.
Steady on, Craig. I love a bit of UFC.
It's got to be the rugby for me.
And me.
Oh,
Oh my God!
I love all that thunder from down under.
And don't forget the cricket.
There's plenty of athletics as well.
And the top class motor sport, why would I go anywhere else?
Satanta Sports. Your passion is our passion.
Plenty to look forward to, but Kazakhstan, England to look forward to now. Prediction, Macca.
3-0.
England.
Yeah, oh, sorry, yeah, of course, yeah. After I've been talking about it all night,
I know. Rooney on your score sheet. Terry, as we wait the England team.
I go 4-0.
4-0.
What about you?
I couldn't possibly say. But plenty of goals, that's what we want.
Yeah.
Let's go over to our commentary team with Chris Waddle and John Champion.
Thank you, Angus. Good afternoon, everybody. Good evening, really, from 5 hours east of you, 3,500 miles away. Chris, it's alien environment, difficult pitch, spirited opposition. What's the key for England here?
The key is the tempo. They've got to come out quick. They've got to unsettle his side. They've got to get among them, get them in, push them back on the back foot. Set piece has always been key with England, but I think they'll get enough space if they play a high tempo on the ball.
Well, England's World Cup tour has encountered continental drift. And they find themselves in a part of the world that really only FIFA and UEFA could ever consider to be European. The same distance from London as Chicago, a short hop from Afghanistan, barely an hour by train from China. But whether Kazakhstan belongs to Asia or Europe, this, without doubt, is the biggest sporting occasion in this fast-developing country's history. Many relics of the Soviet era remain. We and these players are in one of them, the Central Stadium, built when Khrushchev was in power, and apart from a few plastic seats, barely touched since. These players making their way down the tunnel with its ruffled carpet and its cardboard ceiling, and then taking care not to bump their heads on a fairly low concrete beam. Up the steps they come, across the threadbare tartan running track. Then John Terry and co will encounter a playing surface that they may well find to be challenging. It was flooded by a storm on Tuesday, dry and rutted by yesterday, and cut for a second time in 24 hours only this morning. A full house of 25,000. Tickets for league games here cost 25p. For this game, £50. They've never known an occasion quite like it in this 18-year-old country. And 1,300 official England supporters, quite a few more unofficial. None of the description of the stadium denigrates the efforts of the Kazakhstan people in making England feel welcome. The Premier League watched avidly here. But it is a day in the spotlight for a young country seeking an identity in the modern era. A window on the world for Kazakhstan. Famously in the past lampooned, but as we've found out these past 4 days in this very hospitable country, unashamedly proud of what they have and what they represent. Announcements in Russian, in Kazakh, and now in England. A word of welcome from the stadium announcer preceding the national anthems.
This is an England and Republic of Kazakhstan state anthem.
with words modified by the country's president, Nursultan Nazarbayev, who's here today. The handshakes led by England's redoubtable captain, John Terry. The England team is as expected. For the first time, a Capello lineup doesn't include David James. And with Ben Foster also injured, there's a long-awaited first start for Robert Green. Matthew Upson deputises for Rio Ferdinand. Theo Walcott plays his first international in 8 months. And despite Peter Crouch's goal last time out against Ukraine, Emil Heskey returns to lead the attack. The substitutes include David Beckham, but not Gary Neville, who's got a foot problem.
Well, obviously our eyes will be on Robert Green, but I'm looking at the back four. Colin Johnson will be occupied tonight with two good wingers. But I'm looking at Walcott, Gerrard, Rooney and Heskey to get a hold of the ball to bring these three into the game, and that's where England can win the game.
Well, like England, Kazakhstan named 8 of the 11 who started when the sides met at Wembley last October. All the players earn their living here. Their coach Ben Stork compares the standard of the Kazakhstan Premier League to the Blue Square Premier in England. They've lost their captain and most cap player Ruslan Baltiev to a knee injury, but watch out for support striker Nusabayev, who should have scored at Wembley, and left winger Kukayev, who did.
I think that's what the team's about. The two midfield players will just sit. Kukayev on the left, very good player. Nusabayev, again, a very, very good player. And I'm looking at Avichenko on his debut, very pacey. Will occupy Ashley Cole.
Well, Arsene Wenger suggests that Theo Walcott shouldn't be playing over the summer as he risks burnout, but 4 months off injured mid-season means this is only his 13th start in 7 months. Contrast that with Gareth Barry, whose choice of Champions League wages over Champions League football has caused such comment. His season began in mid-July in the Intertoto Cup, and this is his 58th game. Mind you, he earns in 3 days what Kazakhstan's burly striker Sergei Ostapenko earns in a year. He tried to make it in the Belgian second division, but failed to get a game. So there is a huge contrast between the two sets of players on World Cup duty here. World Cup Group 6, comprising England and 5 other football teams who 20 years ago didn't even exist. And whilst England have sent Mike Dean to referee in Iceland this evening, Iceland have sent Kristinn Jakobsen to officiate here, albeit with a 24-hour delay at Heathrow en route. He got here in the early hours of this morning. Kazakhstan in blue. They tend to start games well and then fade. For Kazakhstan, this is historic. For England, the hope is that it will be routine. But Glenn Johnson has lost the ball to Kukayev, and Ostapenko with a chance! It's John Terry that clears off the line. What a scare for England in the opening seconds. Nearly a start to rank alongside that in the cup final a week ago.
Well, if you're going to rest the team, England come out the blocks quick from the kickoff. Blocked it. Glenn Johnson dawdling it right back on the ball. Give them credit. He should have scored.
That was a glorious chance for Sergei Ostapenko. And a real warning for England that Kazakhstan cannot be taken for granted. In fact, that should be a warning that rings loud in English sport today after the efforts of the Dutch cricket team yesterday. Here's Lampard. Drift out of play, and England still breathing a huge sigh of relief.
Well, a chance. Glenn Johnson, court possession. Very bright Kukayev, excellent player. Great ball. He took his eye out as the Ostapenko, really. He's just got to get any contact, and that's 1-0.
This time Ostapenko is after chase, which is not his strength. He is, frankly, a poor man's Bob Latchford. But he could have had a moment of real glory that would have lasted him a lifetime. Logvinenko misses it, and it'll go through second bounce to Alexander Mokin, who kept goal very well at Wembley but struggled against the cross ball.
I'm surprised, John. I'm sure Fabio Capello said this team for 45 minutes are as good as anything in the group, which they proved. Second off, everybody knows this team will tire, and that's where England, I think, will control. But you can't afford to give a team like this a gold star.
Some of the England players still this morning feeling a little leggy after their 8-hour flight. Just the time difference that's really the problem here. It's the same as flying from New York to London, coming east is always difficult. This is Theo Walcott, though, looks lively. When it came to delivering the cross, well, he's saying that he was having his shirt tugged at. The playing surface is also not the best here.
No, not the best. Great pace, so that's what he's good at. Look how he just opens his legs, get away from a kick-off. He did tug him at first, but now when he's got the chance to clear it, it had actually hit his left foot before he kicked it with his right.
Last seen in England colours in Belarus. And then dislocated his shoulder in training before the friendly in Germany. Kayev and Nusabaya got in each other's way. Gareth Barry, here's Wayne Rooney.
That's what they can't afford to do. And I think that's what the coach was worried about when he talked to him earlier in the week, wasn't he? About Wayne Rooney dropping off into that little gap behind the midfield, picking it up and releasing Walcott.
There is the coach, Ben Storck, formerly a right-back with Borussia Dortmund. His main claim to fame prior to tonight, marking Maradona in a European game against Barcelona. Kukeyev, such from Nusabaya. This is Kukeyev again. Kukeyev, the player who scored as a result of Ashley Cole's wayward pass at Wembley in the autumn.
I think people will be taking note of a couple of these players. I think they could do a job in England. I'm not saying Premier League, but they could definitely play at that level.
Kislitsyn, caught by Gerrard.
That's what they've got to do. Wayne Rooney started that by chasing the goalkeeper down. Steven Gerrard follows him up the field and they get a reward.
Bounces off Gerrard's head, that'll be a goal kick. This is not the start that Fabio Capello was looking for. Players dare not ease off when he's around. If Capello says jump, their response is usually how high.
What he's trying to say to John Terry,
happy, does he?
Sorry, John. What they're trying to say to John Terry is get on the halfway lane, the goalkeeper cannot reach. Why is he in 25 yards behind halfway lane?
He's very animated at the moment, Capello down below us. Ben Johnson struggling against Kukeyev again. Very demonstrative. Furious by the looks of it.
Well, he does make his feelings known, and he's one of them managers who will let any player know. He hasn't got favourites, has he?
Rooney. Here's Lampard.
That's where England will dominate the game for me tonight. They're in the middle of the park. The two boys in, sitting in there, they're going to feign it very hard. Rooney making a three. They're just getting outnumbered every time England go forward.
Terry. Rooney. Off goes Heskey. Defender is Logvinenko. Plays for Aktobe, the top side in the Kazakhstan Premier League, but one of the three teams refusing to cooperate with the national team coach over fitness regimes. Ashley Cole. There's Mokin. Still the old Soviet suspicion of the new methods brought in by the German coach here.
Well, that's unfortunate. He's trying to improve. We had a good chat with him, and he really does want to make... he's got some great ideas, some great plans. Unfortunately, they'll not follow up on them.
And trying to introduce personal training programs, heart rate monitors, lactic acid tests, blood tests, all unheard of in this part of the footballing world. It's being met with great resistance. He says the fitness level of his players now is worse than it was 2 months before the start of the season. Here's Ostapenko. Alexander Kirov. Sergei Skorik. It's a great shame that it is now dark local time, just after 9:05 at night, because this ground, this city, is surrounded by the most spectacular snow-capped mountain range. Walcott's free from Iceland, sees enough of a foul to give a free kick. Christian Jakobsen unhappy with that, and a yellow card.
Musabayev. He wouldn't let Frank Lampard, he wouldn't get to retreat the yardage required, and blocked the free kick by Frank Lampard and got himself a yellow card.
The offence, Tanat Nusabayev, not one of those, already on a booking in the group. Free kick taken by Barry, glanced by Upson.
Maybe it was a little bit too deep, I think, to put it in the box. Why don't they work a couple of passes? John Terry's up there, Matthew Upson's up there. Just keep a little bit of possession, work a bit angle to put in. It's a very straight free kick into the box, very easy to deal with.
Ostapenko was Upson. Heskey. Gerrard taken off him by Skorik, cleared by Kiznitsyn. England's free kick.
Well, this is another position similar to the one I've just seen. John Terry this time and Upson not going up. I think England should work the ball as Gareth Barry's passed it off.
Is Lampard, whose goal decided the FA Cup final a week ago. John Terry, who lifted the trophy. Ben Johnson.
I can see Capello's give him a little clap there, but there's so many easy passes on, and England are trying to force it at the moment. Everything's going long, 40, 50 yards, whether it's to Heskey or to Gerrard on this occasion. And you've got to really get some passes, enough room in that midfield for Lampard and Barry to get on the ball.
Kiznitsyn. There's not much too sophisticated about that. And that came last off Upson, and even though he attempts to take the throw, it is Kazakhstan's. Nusabayev. Barry. Gerrard. World Cup beginning to motor on the far side. Rooney up with him. Heskey's made a diagonal run inside him. Barry. Ben Johnson. Another wayward England pass.
Oh, Capello was applauding it. It was some good possession by England. Moved the ball, switched the play, got it back to the back four. Just a lack of movement from Wayne Rooney and Heskey. They've sort of made a couple of runs and thought, well, we're not going to get it. So they didn't move this time. Upson plays it down and goes out for a goal kick.
Kislitsyn. Retrieved by Lampard. And wasted by Lampard. Johnson.
I've got to say, the pitch is bubbly, dry. But England look very nervous at the back.
Well, you mentioned the pitch, and there are some interesting features to it, notably that patch of AstroTurf by the corner flag, part of which is the pitch itself, you can see from the line, and that actually is on top of a manhole cover.
And the other corner's the same, it's very poor. I was very surprised FIFA didn't do something about it, even if it shortened the pitch to make it better, but that is absolutely scandalous.
I think the problem is, Chris, that the pitch is already at the minimum length that it's allowed to be. Ostapenko. Rooney. Johnson shrugging off Kukea this time.
You've got to give the front three a lot of credit. The way they, the pace they've got, the way they chase people down.
When Nusabayev has gone down, he's picking himself up slowly. We don't want to lose him because he's a real live wire for Kazakhstan.
I just got for England. Just play short, there's enough space. Steven Gerrard tucks in well, there's a lot of space. They've got to play to feet and they've got to have confidence and belief in their ability.
It's a scrappy start to this World Cup qualifier, and then Gareth Barry pulls back Kukayev, and this could well cost Barry a yellow card, and it's a yellow that earns him a night off when Andorra visit on Wednesday.
Caught in possession, very, very slow, no awareness. And again, it was Kukayev the same, we put them under pressure.
Second yellow of the qualifying tournament, so he serves a one-match ban. Ostapenko, remember, Kazakhstan should have scored inside the opening 20 seconds here. Skorik. Ashley Cole, all he can do is boot it into the crowd, nearly as far as the presidential box. Avchenko goes down.
Well, this will be very interesting. It's a bit of spine this week at their training camp. Here he comes across, but he takes a wicked free kick and corner. Here he goes, he's going to bend this in. He aimed for the far post with a lot of pace on it, and he's trying to get all the blue shirts across it. And if nobody touches it, it may go straight in the far corner.
Well, he must be a decent player because green boots are mighty hard to come by in Kazakhstan. Watch out for Abdulin here and for Ostapenko. It's Kukayev in towards Ostapenko. Flags up! Flags up! The celebration will be cut short. And England get a reprieve from the referee's assistant. In fact, they've taken the free kick with Kazakhstan still celebrating. Referee won't allow this to continue. Whilst Ostapenko is still marking what he thinks is a goal, Ashley Cole galloped the length of the pitch. They should have scored one through Ostapenko. He thought he'd scored another.
Well, from where sitting in, it looked like a great delivery at the far post. We talked about it. He's gone around the back. He's just a fraction offside. He is. The linesman's got it spot on. Now there'll be a debate. It's a great hit at the far post, but there will be a debate. Should you let it play on after that? I think he got it right. They went away celebrating, didn't see the flag, and he's brought the play back.
But just a bit of context here. England ranked sixth in the world. Kazakhstan number 132. And Kazakhstan could have scored twice.
Well, it was offside, and the marking, John Terry will probably say he got it right, letting them run offside. But very risky business. I don't think he would have noticed that. It was a good header, good ball. And as you say, John, open 20 seconds, they should have scored then as well. The same player.
Well, he looks like a lower division centre forward, but he's troubling some of Europe's finest defenders. Here's one of them, John Terry. Lampard. Logvinenko. Kazakhstan have only ever won three competitive internationals. Their best win here against the Serbia team, including Nemanja Vidic a couple of years ago. They've also beaten Armenia and Andorra. So it's not a great cast list.
I just think that, unfortunately, the coach is spot on. He said first half, didn't he, that they play a good tempo, they press teams, and technically they're very, very good. But they just can't sustain it. So if they don't get, maybe they don't score before half time, and you've got to say it's game over second half.
Kirov, the supplier. It's an awkward 6-yard box in which Robert Green is operating at that right-hand end of the pitch. He has been warned about it by the England staff. It's probably the worst area of the playing surface. So clearing kicks must be executed with great care. And they've only got one ball on the pitch. For more. Johnson in haste.
Brilliant pressing on the ball though. The well, first one he missed, Glenn Johnson did very well, didn't he, to get away from him, but he's up, he's after him again and makes Glenn Johnson kick a ball, what, 56 yards out of play. And that's been the secret for me, the Kazakhstan. They've harassed England, but when they've got the ball, they've looked bright, they look like they can create.
They will run out of steam. It's a question of how much damage they've done to England when that point arrives, which will probably be a quarter of an hour or so into the second half. Ashley Cole's misplaced header. Scoring. Ostapenko. He slips in. Kazakhstan have a casualty. Ostapenko. Sufficiently serious for the referee to call a halt. And the former boxer, Ostapenko, is on the canvas.
Well, you can see, I thought he was going to blow on this challenge here. And he should have. He let play go on. I thought he would have brought the play back now. He said that was a free kick, and have a word with Gareth Barry and say that's your last chance.
Because Barry is on a yellow card. Here where the problem is. But for the linesman, Ostapenko would be on the score sheet.
Well, it's a good delivery. He didn't need to go as early as he has, but it's a good ball in. It's Robert Green's in no man's land, and that's a free head at the far post, and England can think themselves very fortunate.
Nearly the most famous moment in the history of Kazakhstan football, but it's not looking wildly good for Sergei Ostapenko. He's in self-evident pain. They don't really have a like-for-like replacement for him. Not too many Bob Latchford lookalikes around in Kazakhstan.
It may, John, just suit them to play Musabayev up front, play three, two wide and one up front, and put another body in midfield, which would help them.
Well, the signal has gone to the Kazakhstan bench that they do need to make a change. They defend with 10, that's Rooney.
That was a decent effort. He had to have the shot from, what, 25 yards? Always going high and over the bar. A little bit better by England. Playing a nice 1-2 with Gerrard. Great flick off by Steven Gerrard. Good effort by Rooney.
Well, one member of the Kazakhstan staff has been dispatched behind the right-hand goal to go and find a substitute. They've not managed to attract the relevant player's attention. Whilst Reinhard Mertz, the physio, assists Ostapenko. Here's Glenn Johnson for England. And not for the first time, Kukeyev causing him quite a bit of trouble. Avachenko's going through the middle. Upson. Musabayev. Kirov. They're planning to bring on Ibrayev, Kazakhstan, who is a right-sided midfield player. What a sad end for Ostapenko. Lampard looks for Ashley Cole. And England are not finding their men with any consistency here. Ibrayev started at Wembley.
I thought he would be playing when we were watching him training. He was on the right-hand side of midfield the day before the game, so the coach changed his mind at the last minute.
It's taken me a while to make Ibrayev ready. Kazakhstan only have 10 on the pitch still. Here he comes, Sabir Khan Ibrayev. Plays for Tobol, who are mid-table in the Kazakh Premier League. One of the rebel clubs in terms of declining to assist the national team coach. Logvinenko. Kiznitsa. Walcott. Here's Lampard. Rooney. Ashley Cole. Barry. And at long last, here's the change. Stricken Ostapenko replaced by Ibrayev. And we wait to see, Chris, but it looks like Avachenko will switch position.
Avachenko will go on the left side. No, he's not. He's going to go up front. He's a very quick player, and he's leaving it, really. He's just putting Ibrayev on this right-hand side.
John Terry. Johnson skip away from Barry. And yet more live international football to come here on Setanta Sports. On Monday evening, we have England under-21s against Azerbaijan from Milton Keynes. England send off before the Euro Championship finals in Sweden. And then next Saturday, it's the England schoolboys against the French under-18s.
Just looking at England as well, they've made a change. They've put Steven Gerrard in the role he plays at Liverpool just off the striker. And they've brought Wayne Rooney, who has been playing left side of midfield for Manchester United.
Kev has won a throw. Looking at the evidence so far, Chris, this German coach of Kazakhstan has got a bit of raw talent to work with.
I think they're a good side, but as he's told me this week, the fitness levels are poor, they tie up very easily, but so far, we've got to say they should be in the lead.
It's a poor clearance though, straight to Heskey. It's Gerrard. And it's Emil Heskey! Saved by the woodwork. Goalkeeper may well have got a touch as well.
First decent chance for England. Heskey, it's a good strike, he's hit it right. It's a bad clearance, you notice the Nate. Maureen, he's striking off the ball, McKean's terrible up there. Distance, it's a good strike, it's a good save under the post.
Lampard's corner kick. Now, was there some holding there? England felt so. Matthew Upson went for the ball, Capella leads the appeals, nothing doing from the Icelandic referee.
Well, we'll have to see this. Matthew Upson went down a little bit easy. Eski's getting held for definite, you can see on his replay. Here he comes in. He's attacking the ball, Matthew Upson, he's just in the back and I didn't see a great deal here. I think he went down maybe a little bit too easy for the referee.
Big old kick. Well, England's welcome here has been very warm. There's a message from the Football Federation president in the programme tonight, which is worth a little bit of repetition. Tonight we're going to watch the football of international class. Kazakhstan national team is going to try a fall with guests from the country where football traditions had been establishing from the incipience of the great game. Sums it up, doesn't it? Welcome to Kazakhstan. This guy, I think, is okay. And he will certainly recover in time for this corner. Started a warm-up, that's why there's a ripple in the crowd. There's Upson, Avachenko. Gerrard won't get to it, it's a brave challenge. Kukan. He excites the crowd whenever he's on the ball as Walcott slides across.
I think the lady's got good pace, very direct, he goes and commits defenders.
It's worth repeating that Kazakhstan do fade dramatically. Johnson. When they played at Wembley, it took 52 minutes for England to break them down. Their last fixture here, they led Belarus at the break and then still lost 5-1. This is Nusabayev.
I like the look in Sabayev, I think, two good feet, great turn of pace up, and he just thought he lines it up and then he's away.
Cole, Barry, here's Gerrard, Rooney. Cole, now Gerrard again, deliberate from England. Walcott. Kirov. Kukeev. Kirov's continued his run. And Avachenko's getting there in the middle. Down goes Kirov, no free kick.
Good football. Theo Walcott, apart from the opening couple of minutes, has really struggled to get in this game.
As he did against Kazakhstan at Wembley. Steven Gerrard. Cole. Wanting up his scoring. Spotting his way towards the dugouts as his teammates seek the goal that he thought he'd managed to find.
Well, that was sloppy play by Steven Gerrard of all players, and that's basically summed England up for me the first few, 32, 34 minutes. They've just been sloppy. They haven't won any battles all over the park. Kazakhstan look more hungry. They're really competing. They want every ball what drops. They're pressing England, and England really now should have realised that you've got to press a team, you've got to work harder. You may have to mix it up, Hedhesky, but nobody backs them up. It's easy for them to pick the ball up, Kazakhstan.
Now, Walcott's got three for the first time, really. Cross comes Logvinenko and times it well. Nusabayev. One back by Johnson for Upson. And now Ashley Cole. England played 5-1-5 in Group 6. 5 points clear of Croatia, 8 of Ukraine. There have been some sticky moments along the way. And this is proving to be one of them. Walcott, Heskey. Extravagant touch.
Well, the string, two or three passes, but there's nobody wanting to drive at the back four. There's nobody wanting to get around the back. There's no movement.
And here's Gareth Barry. Walcott, and again, Logvinenko commits. Kukeev can't prevent the corner. So we're in manhole territory. Not a problem for a right-footed taker. Frank Lampard. John Terry.
Easy header for John Terry, wasn't it? Just a simple crossing by Frank Lampard. And there he goes, John Terry jumps nice and early. Bit of a late challenge on him. Comfortable save for the keeper.
Wants to take this quickly. Nusabayev. Ibrahim again. Handling towards Avachenko. And Skorik. Ball does run away quickly on this awkward surface. It's a warm evening. Fairly humid as well. Temperature around about 24 degrees at kickoff. Barry, Cole, Terry,
it just sums England up for me this first half, John. every time the ball's at the back, I'm looking, you know, Heskey, can he come short? Can Rooney go? Can Lampard go long? Can Walcott go long and come short? The movement is so poor at the moment. So when you stand at the back, yes, Upson's been caught possession, John Terry's lost possession, but there's nothing happening ahead of them. You know, it's about off the ball running at the moment. Move these players around, it's very easy to play against.
Kazakhstan performing well without Ruslan Valtiev in the centre there, their most capped player and captain. He's got a knee problem. Free kick Kazakhstan, won by Nusabayev.
The kick ever will come across as he does. Unfortunately, the big centre forward's gone off.
And the last one of these did locate Ostapenko. So now Abdulin goes forward, number four, the rugged central defender. Scored in the last qualifier against Belarus from a set piece, and he's occupying the Ostapenko position, the deepest Kazakhstan player of all. Delivery's good, isn't it?
He's got fantastic delivery, puts a lot of pace inside the foot, very hard to deal with.
Turn away from two, and a good ball as well, Ashley Cole. Logvinenko covering well again.
Very good movement. But you're looking at Ashley Cole, who's a fullback, who's really ran, 40 yards? Great ball by Rooney. Good bit of defending.
Corner taken short to Gerrard. Gareth Barry's there, and Gareth Barry's header has found the net. And suddenly the cloud of worry lifts from England's shoulders.
Well, you've got to think, who's marking Gareth Barry? Steven Gerrard, short corner, just well to get it on his left foot, allowed to cross the ball. It's a good delivery at the far post. And Gareth Barry, he's just standing on his own. He's just ran around the back, there's nobody picked him up. They're all ball watching. And he just heads it the right way, down into the ground, back across the goal. And it's such a simple goal. That's definitely against the run of the play for me.
So the only player to have appeared in every international since Capello's mould-changing arrival finds the net in England colours for only the second time. It's been a fairly monumental week for Gareth Barry and for his bank manager.
Not wrong. Well, just see how Kazakhstan react. Not long off half-time. No, they've had an excellent... so far in the game, they've been excellent.
They often pay for moments of defensive carelessness, and that's been the case here. They conceded 4 in 16 minutes against Belarus. 5 in little more than half an hour at Wembley.
They shouldn't feel down, though. And I'm sure the coach, the manager, he's got to tell them this. You know, they've played very, very well. They've created problems. They've won all the battles over the park.
Kukaev. There's the goal scorer Barry sorting matters out. Abdulin. Cole. Gerrard. Heskey. Slipped it inside, but Walcott is offside.
Not better movement, though. That's what England need to do. And they can get a lot more goals. This time, Heskey coming short. Walcott on his bike. And he's just fractured. I think Leithman got that red as well. So, unfortunately, but good movement.
Kirov, the left back. question politely being asked by Kazakhstan as to whether there was a foul there for Kaya. And away now by Karpovic, the captain. Abdulin. Skorik, Ryan. Shortly, England will be heading back into their fairly shabby quarters, their dressing room, more like a civil servant's office. Avachenko, Karpovic, and away by Rooney.
It seems that Kazakhstan have played some nice football, but they're allowed to play so easy to get through England. I'm sure Fabio Capello will be delighted to go in at 1-0, but Matthew can be very poor and Kazakhstan will feel hard done by.
Kazakhstan have got the decision. The testing half for England is drawing towards a close. We're expecting two additional minutes, largely for the treatment for Ostapenko. Capello was keen to stress yesterday when he addressed the travelling media that he would take a scrappy performance as long as it was a winning result. Looks like it may go that way.
Well, I think he's got his wish. It's been expecting a lot more second half. Kazakhstan, I'm sure, will tire. But so far, he'd be delighted with the result, and that's all. The performance, very average.
Ashley Cole. John Terry. Now Barry, the goal scorer. Lampard, there's the fourth official down below us. 2 minutes confirmed. Ibrahim. Kukeyev. Oh, bumped into his own player. That allowed Upsonin. Gerrard. Oh, goalkeeper stranded. Heskey, two. And what was Alexander Mokin playing at? Way off his line. No man's land, really. All he could do was parry Gerrard's effort from distance. And Emil Heskey on hand to pounce. And England will enjoy a position of half-time comfort that perhaps they don't deserve.
I thought it was a deflection. I think he judged the pass from Steven Gerrard. I'm sure there's some type of deflection. And yes, it did. It come off the midfield boy, Skorik. And that caught the keeper out. He did what he could. Yes, it's come off Skorik. He's off his lane. He's very unfortunate at the ball's job. Give Heskey a lot of credit. He's followed in, which good strikers do. And it's a decent finish with his left foot.
And now Kazakhstan trying from range. So, two goals in the space of 6.5 minutes. And Emil Heskey, a rarity for him, scoring in back-to-back internationals. It's his first competitive goal for England since the 2002 World Cup finals against Denmark. Deflating for Kazakhstan, scoring. So they look very capable of going in level at worst. The goal disallowed for offside, should well have scored really inside 20 seconds. But England have grabbed the initiative very firmly here now. Kirov, Avachenko, Johnson wins out. and give the free kick. The Icelandic official blows the whistle for half-time. And a very different complexion to the game now, thanks to goals late in this first half from Gareth Barry and then Emil Heskey. And all of this after Kazakhstan had made much of the early running. There was plenty to concern the travelling England support until the 38th minute, when Gerrard's deep cross was headed back across the goalkeeper by Gareth Barry. And Gerrard also involved a deflected ball forward, catching out keeper Mocky, and Heskey scoring only his seventh international goal on the occasion of his 53rd cap. So the scoreline straightforward. Kazakhstan have played very well and have had their moments, but England have enjoyed the moments that really count through Barry and Heskey. And at half-time in the central stadium in Almaty, a long way from home, is Kazakhstan 0, England 2.
Job half done. Not that comfortable, but a scoreline that reads well. Catch up with day three of the Memorial Tournament at 5:30 over on Setanta Golf, 9 o'clock here on Setanta Sports 1. If golf is your bag, we have the World Cup qualifier from Group 8, the Republic in Bulgaria. That's 25 past 6 here on Setanta Sports 1. That follows us. And also you can see highlights from Azerbaijan against Wales at 9 o'clock over on Setanta Sports 2. Plenty of World Cup qualifying action here on Setanta Sports this afternoon and this evening. It is a results game, and the result at half-time is good. Macca and Terry give us their thoughts next. More international football coming your way Monday night, 7:15, from Milton Keynes. England under-21s against the Azerbaijan under-21s. And then next Saturday, 2:45, the England schoolboys against France under-18s. So England lead 2-0 at half-time. Does that reflect the first half, really?
No, I think we were asking for England to start sharp, quick, fast, press them. They didn't do any of that, but, you know, thankfully Kazakhstan have the capability of collapsing at any moment on the day. And you see simple cross, Steven Gerrard, left foot to the far post, and Gareth Barry, we haven't highlighted, easy header back across goal, unmarked. And I think that's the problem with the lesser nations. Set pieces, free kicks, corner kicks, they're always very, very vulnerable. And you know, all credit to Gareth Barry. England have struggled in the first half, but, you know, to lead 2-0 at half-time, you know, is more than we can ask for.
Exactly.
I think what happened as well there, they were marking at the corner kick when that was taken, and then the three defenders come up very late, and then they saw them, and then they went to move to them and shifted the whole of their side. It was just a simple, you know, schoolboy error. I mean, it is true that they're not good at set pieces, and I think we are. This was deflected, actually.
Yeah.
It was deflected off a defender. You see it from here, there.
Yeah.
So therefore, it went over the top of him. And Heskey, he's not blessed with a lot of luck in front of goal. He happens to get some luck this time, and good for him.
He'd hit the post earlier. Yeah.
Yeah, hit the post earlier, and we thought that was Emil again being unlucky. You know, doing everything but put the ball in the net, and he got a little bit of luck, a little deflection off Skoric, and the Mocken was just out of position, wasn't he? And puts it into Emil's path, thankfully.
Now, you talked about how important it was for England to get a good start.
Start quickly.
Really important, because this is within no time at all, 19 seconds. We're talking about how well we've played the ball early. Here, he has a touch and another touch, and he gets himself in trouble, Johnson.
Yeah.
You know, and he puts a lovely ball in, and Ostachenko is very unlucky not to get a touch on it, to just tickle it into the net.
Yeah.
There it goes, he draws the goalie out.
Yeah.
Took a good position.
Yeah.
But here he goes again. We're a bit fortunate, I think. A goalkeeper comes really, we should just protect his goal and leave it to defenders. And he doesn't put this flag up straight away. He waits till it's almost on his head when he's not offside and puts it in the net.
I think it's a great decision in hindsight. Well, when you look at it, it was a brilliant decision. But, you know, a lot of the times we've seen those kind of decisions that the linesman keeps his flag down. The fact that he's keeping an eye on the free kick and across the line as well, I mean, all credit to the linesman. But that could have easily been a goal, and it would have been a big mistake, because it was poor defending and poor goalkeeping in the end.
Ostapenko has been a threat right from the early part. And up until the time he went off, they believed in him.
Yeah.
And they had a lot more belief.
Yeah.
And the thing is, I think Johnson and Barry particularly, but all the team, wanted a extra touches of the ball. They're going to close you down. So move the ball. One touch, two touch, move it, move it. And it was about half an hour before we had a spell of one and two touch football. That's the way you break it down. Because if you have an extra touch, bang, they've got you. And we were pedestrian. Barry and was certainly pedestrian in that first.
Okay, pedestrian it may have been, but 2-0 England lead at half time. On course for victory number 6, Fabio Capello. The second half in Almaty, coming right up. Underway next week. Start of the Athletic Golden League Athletics next Sunday at 2 o'clock. There it is, 2 o'clock next Sunday here on Setenta Sports One. The first of 6 meetings in which a share of $1 million is up for grabs. A change at half time for England. Sean Wright Phillips is coming on for Theo Walcott. Thoughts behind that, Macca?
Yeah, I think he just wants more. He wants more off the. Well, I think the right side. Theo was struggling, and Glenn Johnson's been struggling. So Sean will give him a little bit more protection, and hopefully a lot more going forward.
Okay, let's get back to Almaty, and Chris and John.
Well, the grand plan for Kazakhstan is to qualify for Euro 2016. It's a way off, and they reckon they're 20 years behind most of the rest of Europe. They've given a good account of themselves so far against an England team who now lead through goals from Barry and Heskey late in the first half. Position of rare comfort beckons for England if they turn this half-time lead into a win. 18 points from 6 games. Andorra to come at Wembley on Wednesday. They'd have one foot in South Africa. So just the one change by England. Right, Phillips for Walcott. It's hardly wildly surprising. And no changes from Kazakhstan.
Well, you expect Wright Phillips to try and get this ball and start running at the fullback. Theo Walcott, very disappointing first half, and got himself substituted. But as for Kazakhstan, I was expecting them to come out and have a go for at least 10 minutes, and then I think they will tire. You can see already they're sitting back deep. That intensity they played with in the first half is gone.
Lampard. Given away to Kukeo. Skorik. Nusabayev. Skorik. Terry blocking off Nusabayev. England have a wonderful record against the former Soviet states. 15 previous games against them, 14 wins. Just that one costly defeat against Russia in Moscow at the beginning of last season. Here's Gerrard. Rooney. It's away from him by Ibrahim. Nusabayev. Gerrard.
I'm sure Capello at half times told them to go raise the tempo and push them back. Move the ball quicker, a lot more movement as well, more options.
Terry's tackle. Completing the warm-up. Nusabayev. Kukeo. By Johnson. It's not what Kirov intended. Here's Heskey. Vinyenko.
No card.
Vinyenko for me. That was a clear obstruction. Good play by Heskey. Drawn straight across him, blocked him off. For me, that's a yellow card.
So no booking, but a set-piece opportunity for England. And three of their five goals at Wembley against these opponents came from free kicks. Six in the box for England. Lampard, not a great delivery. And now Kazakhstan could break. This is scoring. Ibrahim. Ryan Phillips. Gerrard. Rooney. Logvinenko.
Yeah, I think England have upped the tempo slightly from half time. They've gotten closer to Kazakhstan. But the final ball is still that little bit of quality what you expect from an England team. It's not happening.
Turn into Terry, he can shoot. Gerrard. Rooney. It's the trailing leg of Kislitsin in the way.
Looks a little frustrated, Wayne Rooney. I know he's been playing on the left-hand side for Manchester United and he doesn't look comfortable out there. He wants to be involved, doesn't he? And tonight, I think what will happen eventually with that, John, is he'll start to lose confidence a little bit in the ability, and I think he's starting to see that in Rooney's game at the moment.
Skorik, Heskey, right, Phillips have been bowled over. Another opportunity for England.
Better delivery, good run by Sean Phillips using all the pace he's got. Oh, he just needed a good delivery from Frank Lampard, missed the first man out.
This is where Kazakhstan are so susceptible. Goalkeeper that's not confident, coming for the ball. Lampard. The right area this time. Ashley Cole. Cole, Cole will come back at him. Thompson, Barry. Tackle came from Karpovic, it was a foul. One of the few Kazakhstan players to have played outside their home nation, had a spell with Dinamo Moscow. This was never a region of the old Soviet Union that contributed much to the Soviet national football scene. Team Kairat Almaty ever made the old Soviet top league. Only one Kazakhstan player ever represented the Soviet Union.
Steven Gerrard and Wayne Rooney swap positions yet again to see if they can get Rooney involved.
Rooney.
Lampard. Lampard's rescued it, having lost it. Rooney finds Gerrard. Gerrard dicks out a shot, feels for a corner, unsuccessfully.
Well, I think their case, I think there was a deflection. But now you can see Kazakhstan, aren't they? They're starting to get a little bit stretched, a little bit tired, and here's there's a challenge. Rooney just plays simple ball off. Gerrard gets the shot off. Yes, it did. It's into Abulin.
Kukea was fouled. Ben Johnson will remember Kukea. Havachenko to Skorik, to nobody in particular. And it's agonising for the coach, Bernd Storck, because he knows that they will fade physically now. He's recruited a number of specialist staff to try and help him in improving stamina. Fabio Capello's England look like they're heading for a sixth consecutive World Cup qualification victory. Fear has always been there that they would just fade to nothing in the second half, hence the message from some of their supporters. Gerrard. Kislitsyn. Two games in the group today, Belarus against Andorra in Grodno, and Belarus have scored first through Luzhniak. It would be a major surprise if it was anything other than a home win. Later tonight, Croatia face Ukraine in Zagreb. Wright Phillips. Johnson. Vinyenko to the tackle with Wright Phillips and concede in the corner.
Try Phillips using his pace again. Good ball by Glenn Johnson. Just down to save the 18-yard box and they've got themselves a corner with the dodgy painted lane where Stephen Gerrard will probably notice now.
It's fairly deep. Barry was arriving. Havachenko, Skorik, Karpovic, again Skorik.
Nice build up with Skorik. He had options left and right, decided to go for the little bit of glory, I suppose. What is he, 30, 35 yards? Well weighed outside the left foot.
Had it flown in, it would have been historic. Vinyenko has taken one in the face there. The challenge, I think, with Heskey. He's saying an elbow was used. And he wasn't wrong.
No, he wasn't wrong, but it's that old one, John, isn't it? You need your arms to raise to get to the height you want, and fortunately sometimes you do catch. I don't think Emil Heskey's that type of player.
Green pass nicely back to Mokin. Ibrahim. So asking an awful lot of Avachenko, quick as he is. Again for the time being. Right, Phillips. Plenty of dignitaries here, including Lord Treisman, chairman of the Football Association. Also in the crowd this evening is Nursultan Nazarbayev, the autocratic president of Kazakhstan, who was elected with 91% of the vote. Surprisingly low, considering he was the only candidate. Logvinenko. Nusabayev. Lampard.
Really lost its pace, the game, wasn't it? It's just sloppy passing. It looks like a lot of tired legs. I was expecting, we knew Kazakhstan would tail, but I think he can sort of come off the pace as well.
Some of them have had a few days on the beach and will return there after Wednesday night's game against Andorra. Others are still waiting for anything in terms of rest. It's already less than a month until pre-season begins. Flags up for offside. Logvinenko. And as Beckham continues to warm up, Walcott is suited and booted, ready for the flight home to Luton. She's due to take off a couple of hours after the conclusion of this game. Tape so far, England struggling until 7 minutes prior to half time.
Yeah, and it was a good ball in. Stephen Gerrard, his left foot, Gareth Barry free. And you've got to say, Kazakhstan, very unlucky. This deflection caught the goalkeeper out of position, and Eski was there to tap it in.
2 in 6.5 minutes after Ostapenko should have scored for Kazakhstan inside 20 seconds, and then had another goal chalked out correctly for offside. In between times, Eski had an effort pushed onto the post for England.
This is a good opportunity, it's a free kick on the edge of the box. Careful, we know he can strike a terrific ball. There's four or five blue shirts around it, they all want it. Kirov very good as well with his left foot from this position.
Well, even a goal against England wouldn't be regarded as something of a national triumph. Kirov or Karpovic? Karpovic takes. Not a bad effort.
Yeah, it's always rising over the bar. I don't think it was going to trouble Robert Green, but yeah, it was a decent strike. You know, he's got over the ball, he's tried to bend it, probably reverse it more than anything, across to the left-hand side of the goal, but always going over the bar.
The limit of Kazakhstan's ambition, really, is honourable defeat. 2-0 after back-to-back 5-1 defeats is comparatively healthy. England will hope and expect to score more. Barry was tripped. Rooney, Gerrard, Nusabayev. He went down spectacularly hoping for a free kick, which he's not got. Kazakhstan, until 2002, played in the Asian Conference. He's in the might of Nepal and the Maldives. So coming within UEFA's remit means a major step up in class. Still bellowing out the orders. Looks like the odd Italian curse as well under his breath. And the goalkeeper uncertain in the air. England knew all about that. Corner.
No, it's decent delivery, but as you said, John, the goalkeeper all night was suspect on crosses here. It's just a simple ball in. Steven Gerrard got tucked down as well. As he was going to attack the ball, could have been a penalty. Just give the corner. Steven Gerrard's gone out there to take it.
Yes, he's on the manhole again. Careful with his footing. Heavy military presence and also police. The blue uniformed officers are the more sensible ones. If you see one in green, keep well away. And they're the ones looking after the England fans by and large.
First 20 seconds and just now, but this time Glenn Johnson, great recovery.
Avchenko. And again, on his debut at the age of 27, Yevgeny Avchenko. Kayev following it in. Green, who will cherish a clean sheet on his debut. Now Lampard. Face pedestrian on what's still a fairly warm night. Right, Phillips. The invalid Ostapenko. Did nod the ball into the England net in the first half. Pulled back for offside. Waving to the adoring legions.
Kazakhstan have done nothing really second half. They haven't come out. They've tired slightly. They're not moving the ball around. And it's there for England to go and say, look, we can get as many as we want. And England's just got slower. The passing's terrible. The movement, they're just walking. It looks like they're quite happy to take the result.
There's a late challenge there by Heskey. John Terry said yesterday, 1-0 will be fine. Don't care about the performance. 2-0 it is. performance is certainly nothing to write home about. Avachenko. Kicked by Wright Phillips, Karpovic, Kirov to Skoric, Pachenko, and now Kislytsyn. And again Kislytsyn, the right back.
Lovely football by Kazakhstan. They went from the left to the right. Good little giving goals. And Kislytsyn stepped in, didn't he, inside. He's got a nice strike on him. Good left foot strike, but good 4 or 5 yards wide. Nice football.
Well, England were stunning in Croatia. Impressive in Belarus. Pretty ordinary against Andorra and Kazakhstan first time around. Probably tonight falls into a similar category. Doing enough. Nusabayev. Ibrayev, Nusabayev. Rooney. Heavy touch by Wright Phillips. Karpovic.
The only thing I can think of, Jonas, is the bar that is the pitch that's bad. I just can't work out. Kazakhstan seemed to pass the ball around lovely.
One thing the crowd now wants to see is the introduction of David Beckham. Kazakhstan's coach Bernd Stork was concerned that his players are fairly awestruck by their opponents and just hoped they would wait until after the match before trying to swap shirts and signing autographs. Here's Gerrard. Rooney's more central this time. There's a deflection on that. Kirov. Rooney. And Rooney tries the chip.
It's a nice idea. The goalkeeper position got it right this time.
Gerrard. Right, Phillips. Johnson. Johnson away from Kukea for once. And Rooney! Wonderful save. Still there. Rooney makes it three. And Wayne Rooney's England hot streak continues. Poor Mokin, he made a wonderful save in the midst of that. But it's 7 goals in his last 6 England games for Wayne Rooney.
Well, Wright Phillips, simple ball only. Give Glenn Johnson a lot of credit, he has. Good strength, persevered, good ball in. Heskey maybe could have scored. Rooney comes off his knee at first, a terrific save. But Rooney's reacted fantastic. Swiveled on it, volley, back across the goalkeeper. Great finish.
Good work by Johnson. Excellent work from Mokin, but then helpless. And Wayne Rooney scores his 6th goal of this World Cup qualification campaign, which makes him 2nd top scorer in the UEFA region of World Cup qualification. Changed by Kazakhstan in the wake of that. Erbes coming on for Avachenko. Nusabaya. Rooney. A man who's plotting an Indian summer by the Indian Ocean next year. Stephen Gerrard. Barry. Ashley Cole. England now the top scorers in European World Cup qualifiers. And here comes the moment that most of the home supporters have come here for. No longer perhaps the showstopper of old, David Beckham, these days reduced to cameos. But with the comfort zone created by the third goal, scored by Rooney, on comes England's talisman, popular, patriotic and persevering. Nelson, cap number 111. Right, Phillips. That was Barry. There's Gerrard, and he takes it on.
Did very well. Great bit of skill. We thought it was going to let it come down and volley it. Just takes it forward. Does everything right. Lovely little header forward. And it's a great block.
Beckham's first touch. Barry, Cole, Gerrard, Heskey having his shirt pulled. Well, he seemed to have it pulled sufficiently for him to go over. On we play, good save, and Heskey goes down again, and this time it is a penalty. And maybe a card to follow as well, yellow for Abdullin.
Well, he should have blew on the first one for me. Heskey was getting pulled down all the second time. He's got it. But great save from Ashley Cole's effort from the goalkeeper. Yes, Abdullin does pull him down, and it's Frank Lampard. Goalkeeper's right.
7 days ago in the plush surroundings of Wembley, Frank Lampard won the FA Cup for Chelsea. 7 days on, 3,500 miles away, he confirms England's victory in Kazakhstan.
Yes, terrific talented. Very good power, high goalkeeper, no chance. Great strike from Frank Lampard. Goalkeeper's right, goalkeeper went low, goes high, well above him. Yeah, terrific penalty by Frank Lampard. That was the first penalty. Bit of, you know, you've got to give it the second one. It's starting to, which we said that to you, and this is where now England can go and get a lot more goals.
Could be an uncomfortable last quarter of an hour, including stoppage time for Kazakhstan now. Here's Skorik. Kukeyev. Johnson's ankle, fairly heavily strapped now. And of course, England have only got 4 days in which to travel home and to get ready for Andorra, a game for which Gareth Barry will be suspended, but Rio Ferdinand may be back. And Fabio Capello, whilst not looking at Jermaine Defoe, is planning to send him on soon.
Yep, and well, I think the fixtures are working in their favour. You know, end of the season, a lot of players normally get a little bit tired, don't they? But to play Kazakhstan, you know, everybody thought it would be tricky in the first half, which it was. But in total control now, and you've got to say it'll be the same on Wednesday night.
So they'll probably get kicked a little more.
Most definitely.
Because that, sadly, is Andorra's way. Heskey. Skoric. Here on offer for England. Gerrard. Well, more live international football follows once we're finished here in Almaty. Stay with us for the Republic of Ireland's World Cup qualifier in Bulgaria. And then over on Satanta Sports 2 at 9 o'clock tonight, you can see highlights of Wales in action as they take on Azerbaijan in Baku. Off comes Emil Heskey, another England goal under his belt.
Yeah, he's done very well. Leads the line very well, doesn't he, Emil Heskey? Strong, very mobile. People say he should score more goals, but in the last couple he has, so yeah, he's answering the critics.
Goals from Barry and Heskey towards the end of the first half, and latterly Rooney and then Frank Lampard's penalty. England 4 goals to the good. Kukaev down in stages, and he's won the free kick.
Yeah, it's a hard first touch. It is very bobbly, the pitch, and you can see Frank Lampard, his first touch just popped up off the ground, and Kazakhstan, as you say, John, they're there for the taking.
International football matches lasted 60 minutes instead of 90. Kazakhstan will be much more competitive. But Kukaev's made an impression. He's only 20. And that scored at Wembley. And is over this free kick now. It is Kukaev. And it's relatively harmless.
Just a little bit too much pace on it. Nobody could. The England held a high line towards the 18-yard box, and you just got to really try and hit the space.
Phillips, now Beckham, Rooney, Kislitsyn, Nusabayev, the linesman flagging, encouraging the referee to blow for a free kick.
Yeah, it was. Nusabayev just got a little touch on the ball before Upson got there, and he just caught him.
Kislitsyn. Deflection on it, took the sting out of the shot. Shows the meticulous nature of Capello's preparation that last night in training, Sean Wright Phillips was deployed at right back, which is where he now finds himself. He's no Gary Neville, he's got an infected toenail. So not on the bench. Kukayev. Right, Phillips. Lampard. And Barry finds Cole. This is now England's first training session in preparation for Andorra.
Well, they've just got no pressure on the ball, not like the first half, where they couldn't control it. They'd give Kazakhstan credit, they got really after them, but now they're just going to bide the time. And if they get the opportunity to get the fifth, I'm sure they'll take it. But at the moment, we'd rather have Kazakhstan chasing them.
Birthday. The man who's changed the mood of the English national team. 14 games in charge, this will be win number 11. Really, they've only taken a proper beating once in Seville when they were dismantled by Spain, and Spain provide the benchmark for them.
Well, I've always said if you're going to beat Spain and South Africa in the World Cup, then you should win the World Cup. I think they're the best team. I think they could go on and dominate for the next 4 or 5 years, the squad they've got. So, as you say, that's the team you've got to beat.
Beckham, one of those quarterback passes, not finding its intended target, Steven Gerrard. Heading on back to the States before long to resume his career with the Galaxy, and looking for another European club at the end of the year. Strange old existence. Rooney for Lampard. Gerrard. Cover from Kirov. Kazakhstan barely had the energy left to attack. Litsin, Skorik, Kukea. Sergei Skorik. Gareth Barry. Kukea. Oh, and a supporter has come onto the pitch, unfortunately. Referee's going to have to blow here. It's not the wisest of moves, bearing in mind the fairly unsophisticated nature of the police here. And there's no standing on ceremony. It's probably one of the poorer decisions of the night.
He's a brave man.
He'll be a bruised man in a minute.
Was that the goal he wanted? Is that why he ran in the net?
Fairly unimpressed. The coach benched off. His worry is that whilst they played well, his federation tend to look at results, not performances.
I think he's done a good job, and he's tried to change, as we were talking about earlier, John, how he's trying to get more fitness into the clubs, and they've got to go with him. I think he's got the right ideas.
Moving rather gingerly. It's not like there's anything seriously wrong. Well, that was high by Gerrard, and he apologises. Referee plays a decent advantage. Airbus. Kukayev. Robert Green was concerned enough to cover that post.
I would talk about Kakev before the game. Talented footballer. I think he'll go along a decent career. I think he'll get a good career, mate, and he can strike a ball very, very well.
Cole. Rooney. Logvinenko. Herbes, Nusabayev, Kukeyev, Kazakhstan is clearly rich in oil and gas and lots of natural resources, but judging by this, in terms of players and fans, rich in enthusiasm as well. Kazakhstan free kick. Belarus have scored a second against Andorra in Grodno. That game an hour behind this one. Croatia and Ukraine meet later in Zagreb. And Ukraine is the next stopping off point for Kazakhstan. They play them in Kiev on Wednesday, at the same time that England face Andorra at Wembley. Fourth official says 3 additional minutes. And here's Gerrard, and Rooney is on his way, and there's not much cover. Rooney picks his spot, and that spot is the goalkeeper.
He did well, Gerrard, threading it through, and he got. You always know when Rooney wants to come back on inside onto his right foot, and he struck it pretty well, but unfortunately aimed straight at the goalkeeper.
Right, Phillips. Now Gareth Barry, whose goal started it all, 7 minutes shy of half time. And England have controlled the second half. Not quite unopposed, but it's been a fairly satisfactory conclusion to a night that started worryingly.
Well, it was worth an effort. They've moved the ball across the box very well, 25 yards. Everybody knows David Beckham can strike a ball, so why not?
Final minute of the night. And the crowd drifting towards the exits. Into the night in Almaty, where the local time's approaching 11 p.m. Here's Karpovic. Those that remain hoping there might be a consolation goal. This is Skoric. Karpovic. Kukeyev. And it was David Beckham that hurled himself in the path of the shot.
That was a great block. Kukeyev was just lined up that right foot again. And I think that might have troubled Robert Green, but David Beckham got across. Terrific block.
Look totally satisfied. It's unusual though, a manager who's approaching his 63rd birthday with not a single grey hair. And why would he have? In the end, a comfortable win. England extend their perfect record. A night of bounty for them in Central Asia. Troubled in the first half,
untroubled in the second. Goals from Lampard from the penalty spot and Rooney after half-time. Before the break, it was Gareth Barry. And then in first half stoppage time, Emil Heskey. A night of cultural learnings all round. Bernd Stork can be proud of his players and their first hour. Fabio Capello deals in results, nothing more, and it's another win, Chris Waddle.
Yes, I don't think they played particularly well. I've got to say, over the course of the game, I thought Kazakhstan played the better football. They got the ball down and passed it, but they didn't have that cutting edge. They nearly took the lead early on, but when they unfortunately didn't get the second goal, which was offside, then England, they've got a bit more quality in front of the goal. And, yeah, we'll talk about the performance. Some people say it's all about the result what counts, but I think Capello, dodgy pitch, obviously he's pleased with the result, but I think England play a lot better than what we saw tonight. I was quite disappointed the way they passed the ball.
Well, three of the remaining four qualification games are at Wembley Stadium, where England have only ever lost twice in World Cup qualifiers. They have one foot hovering over South Africa, sitting in a position of unusual comfort after this victory here tonight. Six wins out of six, and gradually, slowly but surely, banishing those horrid memories of Russia and Croatia at the start of last season. New broom, spectacular results. And on the pitch, England stride forward with confidence towards the World Cup finals. The first smile of the night from the man who has put a smile on the face of English football. England's players leaving the pitch as stars, fated as visitors, welcomed here. Kazakhstan knew that they would lose. They will accept honourable defeat with grace. So both sides have achieved their aims here in the Central Stadium in Almaty. Full-time score in the Kazakhstan-England game, 4-0 in favour of England. Always likely to be that way, but the job has been done satisfactorily.
John and Chris, thank you both very much indeed. So yes, those poor results seem a very long time ago, don't they? Fabio Capello has a perfect record in qualification. So the Group 6 table looks like this now. England 8 points clear of Croatia. Croatia playing Ukraine later on tonight. Kazakhstan still there on 3 points just above Andorra. Over on Satanta Golf now, the Memorial Tournament, day three of that from Muirfield Village. It'll be here on Satanta Sports 1 at 9. But stay with us here on 1, because after we have digested the bits of that game, we will have the Group 8 game between Bulgaria and the Republic of Ireland. 25 past 6 for that here on Satanta Sports 1. That is following us. And more World Cup qualifying action tonight at 9 over on Satanta Sports 2. That's highlights of Azerbaijan against Wales. Well, the scoreline suggests it was very comfortable for England. Well, it was. It wasn't a top draw performance. But as John Terry said before the game, it was the result that mattered, and it's three more points for England, who have been pitch perfect in qualifying. Game two of the NBA Finals tonight. It's Orlando Magic at LA Lakers at the Staples Center. There it is at 10 to 1 over on Satanta Sports 1. Right, let's hear from man of the match, Frank Lampard, who's with Dan.
Frank, a winning goal for Chelsea in the FA Cup final, and now another one in victory for England. It's been quite a week for you.
Yeah, it's been a good week. Obviously, the Cup final was a big highlight, but we had to, personally and as a group, we had to get our heads down, work hard this week and focus on this game. And it wasn't an easy place to come to, albeit we expected to beat them, but conditions, the work rate of them, took us about 20 minutes half hour to get going, and once we did that, we won comfortably.
A long way to come, a difficult pitch at the end of a long, hard season. Given all those things, how good a performance was it by England?
I think it was professional. I think, you know, we can obviously do better, and there'll be bits we can learn from that, particularly our passing in the early stages. We didn't get to grips with the pitch and the flight of the ball, but after that, I think we worked hard, the movement got better, and we're on a confident run at the minute, and we need to keep going.
Six wins out of six. Does it virtually guarantee England, do you think, participation in the World Cup finals now?
Only when we're there. I think we're taking a big step again, which we keep taking now. And another big one on Wednesday. We've got to beat Andorra at home. And then once we've done that, we're nearly there. But we need to make sure until it's mathematically done, we need to keep going.
Can England win it 10 out of 10, do you think, Frank, realistically?
Obviously we can do if we keep playing and keep winning. But I don't know, our main objective is to qualify. The sooner we can do that, the better. And then after that, we can see how we go.
Frank, well done. Man of the match performance. You are the nationwide man of the match. Congratulations.
Another big performance from Frank Lampard. Two goals in each half for England. Professional job.
I think he said it right, didn't he, Frank? It wasn't brilliant. Chrissy Waddle said it was average. And I think Frank put it a bit more succinct, saying it's very professional. It was. And he was correct. First 30 minutes, he wasn't very good. While he comes to adjust with the pitch, and as he said, the flight of the ball, which surprised me. Maybe you know, it did deceive them at times. But they got the job done, and that was all that mattered.
Mm. That is what all that mattered, really, Terry.
Yeah, it's how you go
You'd
about it.
You'd love them to see them play fantastic, but, you know, in the end.
It's how you go about it. We didn't go about it from the first whistle with Johnson. He said they had two or three touches, got robbed, and then everyone's doing the same and getting caught up. And we were passing the ball at each other. I couldn't understand, like, we was hitting it with a sledgehammer. It was like firing them across and going over the top. And then when we started to move it, and then the second half, of course, they weren't really closing down as much, and we did stroke it about and make it work and saw the game out. And you can't argue with 4-0, and you can't argue with 6 out of 6.
No. Are we picking holes rightly? Because it was a poor performance.
I don't think we're picking holes. You can only go on what you see. It's no good us saying it's something that it wasn't. I mean, the fact was we didn't play well. But in saying that, they kept at it and they got the goal. And then they got the second goal. And then you take the sting out of the opposition. It's not the same for them. They've not got a chance. So they're seeing the game out and hoping for pride. I hope they don't get too many goals against them. That's what
I think if we were playing Croatia or Ukraine on Wednesday and had an even bigger game to come, the tempo might have been that little bit quicker. But I think we've got Andorra, it's like, well, we'll beat them anyway. So I think that's why everything was just as much of a stroll in the second half of the game, because it was like, well, I mean, we might as well conserve energy for Wednesday and stroll through that as well.
Against Croatia, I mean, we went off like a firecracker. Yeah. Yeah. And you've got that respect for them. You know they're going to do damage. You know, there's just the underlying thing that you think you're going to... We went out to sort of play as opposed to stop them. You've got to do that, especially in their own garden. Yeah? You've got to do it yourself.
Is that an end-of-season performance, or is that got nothing
no,
to do?
No, I just think it's not a good... It wasn't a good performance. Great result.
Great result.
And you've got to, you know, you've still got to put it in and not make mistakes. Yeah. We've seen those games come off badly for us in the past because of that. They've got their game back on track after half an hour.
I think the most
important
things is the difficult games, the really difficult games away from home, the Croatias, even arguably the Belarus games. We went out and we were excellent, got the job done. Tonight we didn't need to be, but still got the job done. And I think we'll have a mixed bag of them right through the competition. Sometimes you need to be excellent. We were today. I mean, even in the second half when there was acres of space, we were still giving the ball away and everybody was, you know, having a touch and it was bouncing 5 yards off them. So maybe the pitch was as bad as it seemed to be, because it was not a great performance.
5 minutes before half-time was the first goal. Mm. And it's talking about patience.
See those three come back at the end there?
Yes.
They've come up late.
You were talking about that at half-time.
That's right. And he just lets it hit his head and just cushions it into the corner. Simple goal for him.
I mean, it was a Steven Gerrard sort of outswinger with his left foot, wasn't it? It wasn't a traditional inswinger that he does with pace. It was just a simple left foot across the far post. But, you know, unfortunately, the lesser teams, as we mentioned at half-time, don't seem to do the basics right and will always let a goal in at set pieces, or certainly let someone have a free header. And that was very obvious then.
And we've always talked about patience. We'll go back to that first game. And the Andorra game, where it was goalless at half-time. They were booed off at half-time. But it is a team that doesn't seem to panic, you know, if things aren't going quite right.
That's what you've got to have. You've got to have that control and belief in what your game plan. And your game plan is, like we said from the beginning, they'll be saying no different. Even if we've got a few problems, keep at it, keep doing the right things. In the end, you'll play them out. And that's what they did against Andorra. Mm. And I thought, as disappointed as a lot of people were then, you know, those games, when you're not getting it right, you can really come unstuck, and then people panic, go faster, and then get, you know, more erratic with your passing instead of just keep doing the right things.
Yeah, if anything, the Andorra game came after the Czech Republic game, wasn't it, where they were very poor.
Yeah.
I mean, this is the second goal, a touch off Steven Gerrard. It was a cross originally to Emil Heskey. He got a touch off
Skoric, and then the goalkeeper, Mokin, was just a bit lost. And Emil gets a little bit of luck for once, falls to his left foot, and give him his due, he was there in the right place, followed it in, he could have easily just left it, thought the goalkeeper was going to catch it, followed it in, got a simple goal, and I'm very pleased for him.
But by the time you're two up at half-time, you're thinking the job is done. Did you feel that there would be a sort of different emphasis in that second half?
He made the change because I think he wanted to stir things up a bit. He wanted to show that he probably wasn't happy with the right size. You know, Theo Walcott was a little bit invisible, and Glenn Johnson made mistakes. So I think he was trying to make a point as, you know, it doesn't matter who we're playing or what time of game it is, it's 45 minutes. So he just wanted to make a change, stamp his authority to show that, you know, things were not great. And England, they didn't necessarily step it up. If anything, Kazakhstan were a little bit weaker, like exactly what we thought. They did tire, they'd let the better players have more space and more space to capitalise on goals, which England did.
We could have had two or three more.
We could have had more if we wanted to be a bit more ruthless.
Yeah.
This is Wayne Rooney.
This is where we start knocking it about a little bit more, and then we're playing, and he gets himself in front of the defender, Johnson, does very well here, cuts it back, he just knocks it in, and this is a terrific goal. He has to take his non-kicking foot off the ground to be able to get that over. If he stands on his non-kicking foot, he can't hook that up. You watch it as it goes up there. Now, here he goes, up and over it.
Very clever, very bright, wasn't it? Goalkeeper done very, very well. He had made many mistakes, but that was a great save. But that was a very instinctive, very athletic, you know, very agile finish, wasn't it? A brilliant finish from Rooney.
How did you feel that sort of the Heskey, Rooney, Gerrard axis worked? Didn't?
They didn't get as much of the ball as we would expect. I mean, that's why Rooney can drop off, and you've got a good passing alternatives, we normally do. And you've got your wide players coming in if necessary, Rooney coming deep. If you want the longer one, Heskey, Rooney can spin and get involved. So that you've got all your passing combinations ready. But it just spluttered. And a lot of that was because they didn't believe in doing it quick and then building through the team. If you've got to have your players where the ball is. If you're going to play long, you've got to get your players up there for the knockdowns. If you're going to play through the team, it's like a ladder, you've got these steps and we're knocking it long and the players are here waiting for it to feed. And then they were getting a bit frustrated, and some of these, we were hammering balls at each other, and we're saying the first touch was bad, but like it was like crash, you know.
I don't think it was a type of game for that axis to necessarily work today. Yeah. The team dropped deep, didn't they, Kazakhstan, trying to deny space, so it's not as pretty. But again, sometimes you get those games, and then it's up to somebody else to make the space and to make the goals, which invariably we did.
Terry, you said it was going to be 4-0. It was 4-0. A fourth came via the penalty spot after Emil Heskey was tugged down.
Yeah, and they had so many efforts. It looked like the Keystone Cops in there. And of course, we got the penalty. We couldn't knock it in ourselves, so we got a penalty, strikes up, a good time to take it. And he does what he does well. He likes to score, loves to score goals for it.
Thankfully, we've got an abundance of penalty takers at the minute. So it would have been an argument to see who would have taken the penalty tonight, but I think you always fancy Frank at the moment, and he's in a great, rich vein of form.
OK, let's hear from Fabio Capello now. He is with Dan.
Fabio, well done. 6 wins out of 6. Just how good a performance was that by England?
It was not easy to play here this night because the pitch was not fast like the England pitches, and the players play always the passes of the ball more fast. But they started very, very strong. They pressing a lot. We for us was not easy to play the ball, but always when you play against one team that is not the same level, you start very, very strong. And home is the worst. But I'm happy for the performance and for the result.
It was a poor start by England. Were you lucky not to go a goal down?
Yeah. But what's offside? No, it's offside, it's not goal. But we haven't a chance, only one chance. They scored a goal, but was offside. And after we try to play to move the ball quickly, but always when we try to switch the ball was always too long because with these pitches it was not easy to find the measures.
With Andorra next up for you, Fabio, are England now virtually guaranteed passage to the World Cup finals?
We'll be not sure, but it's another big step forward. If we will arrive at 21 points, it's a lot. And we are very happy with 29 points.
On the basis of what you saw tonight, Fabio, if the World Cup finals began tomorrow, could England win it?
No. We haven't to speak about the World Cup. We have to play game after game, and after the next year, when I hope we'll be in South Africa, we can speak about this.
Fabio, thank you. Well done.
He's halfway there.
I think he's virtually there.
I think he's more than halfway.
If they beat, as he said, 21 points, he'll be very happy. If he don't get 21 points on Wednesday, I think it'll be something to worry about.
Is there anything that scoreline hides about the performance today, Terry? I mean, there's still a question mark of Stephen Gerrard and whether positionally it's right over on that left-hand side.
I think that when we've played harder games, it's looked good.
Yeah.
It's looked good, and we're sharp and alert. We know we've got to play to our maximum to play to beat, you know, the Ukraine and Croatia. That doesn't really happen. We've got other problems. You're not going to find out what positions you're going to find, because you're going to go into a mass of players. You've just got to keep believing it. You've got to tighten up on your control, tighten up in your 1-2s, make sure the crosses are accurate, make sure your finishing is good, and that splits them. And once it splits them, they now kind of come out, and then you can go on and do your damage. But I think you can't do much better than what we're doing.
No, I totally agree. I think it's not hiding the fact when we had to go and play arguably our most difficult away game at Croatia, who got the better of us in the last tournament, we went and beat them 4-1. Belarus, we won. You know, when you're 6 out of 6, scoring freely like we have done, well, like, you're not going to be 10 out of 10 every game, but you can only score, you can only win 4-0, can't you, away from home, in a difficult place. We mentioned this before the game, regardless of opposition.
And you expect against Andorra for them to play in exactly the same way, but perhaps it to work better on a pitch that will not
come out. They'll look for damage limitations, that's for sure. They don't want to be humiliated. And that is why the way that what they're believing in is, that's what it is. You know, if you've not got the ammunition to really compete, you know, you've got to try in certain games. You say, well, you know, if once, you know, Kazakhstan comes up, we can do this. And when this one comes up, we can do it. But you've got to make sure you yourself are right. And then once you're right, you and these results behind you and this belief, you can beat anyone.
Take on all
comers. It's a great feeling. You think we can't be beaten.
Andorra are a worse team than Kazakhstan, but arguably Wednesday's game will be more difficult than tonight, because Andorra will just sit 11 men across the back, and it'll be a case of try and break us down. They will not come out, because I tell you, they can't hurt England. So they will just sit, damage limitation. Yeah. If it's 1-0, 2-0, they'll be happy with that.
At least Kazakhstan came out, you know, straight away in the first 20 seconds. You know, this is it. This is from kickoff. England were, you know, could have been a goal down.
It shows more what we were about here. We're sort of watching and waiting with bad control there. It goes back into Johnson. It should go straight to the goalkeeper. No, he has a couple of touches. The guy gets excited, and we could have been one down without a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah.
And we caused that ourselves.
I think Fabio got confused with that incident rather than the headed goal. But we were lucky that Ostapenko just takes his eye off it and doesn't get a touch on it.
And this is the offside goal.
I mean, this was offside, but... Thankfully it was.
Fraction.
I wonder if I don't know whether the players knew it was offside.
Robert Green said.
I don't think Robert Green knew it was offside. Certainly the people in the crowd didn't. You see they were celebrating when but it was a good decision and a right decision.
Yeah.
Any changes to be made before Andorra on Wednesday?
I think he could change it. I think he might maybe start Sean Wright Phillips, or maybe he'll start Crouch. I think he can do. I don't think there should be wholesale changes, but I think he could possibly change people just to give them a go, because I don't think it'll hurt the team anyway. The formation I don't think will change, but maybe a couple of personnel might do them any harm.
The goalkeeper again.
To give him a bit of confidence.
I just think to find out about him in a different situation, different at Wembley, just to see how things go. I mean, it's an area where they have been, you know, we've had sort of difficulties in relying on one person. James has got the position at the moment, but of course with his injury, we don't know how bad that's going to be. So he'll have to concern himself about that.
But it'd be patience again on Wednesday, won't it? Because we know what Andorra will do.
I think we'll find it a lot easier than we did in Barcelona in the first game. But still, I think patience is needed. The crowd need to know that it might take a while, but eventually we will break them down. If you break them down in the first 10 minutes, great, it could be 8-0. But if it's not calm, we'll break them down eventually.
Mm. OK. Terry, Macca, thank you both very much indeed. It's been great to have you. Let me tell you what's coming up right now. Well, over on Satanta Golf, we're already on air, but we'll be here on air on Satanta Sports 1 at 9 o'clock. That's the third round of the Memorial Tournament. That's day 3, of course, and that's coming up at 9 o'clock here on 1. Following us right now, it is the Republic of Ireland, unbeaten so far. They're out in Sofia. It's their Group 8 game from the World Cup qualifying. It's the Republic of Ireland against Bulgaria, coming right up after we've finished. And you'll also be able to see highlights of Wales against Azerbaijan tonight at 9 over on Satanta Sports 2. That's from Group 4. They may not have qualified quite yet, but England have taken another almighty step on the route to South Africa. From us all, bye-bye.